change. Oh, that's right. Oh, hi, boys and girls. Grandma Lolly here. So glad you all are joining me. I'm just looking for my change I earned selling cookies at the local bake sale. I'm going to take this to my quilting club, and we're going to go invest it in a little stock called Apple. We're gonna buy a little 1/10 of a share with it. You know, I love companies that sell fruit, and that just makes me want to get excited and go invest in them all the more. And do you know, this investing thing reminds me of a little story that I want to share with you. I love sharing stories from God's Word, the Bible. And today, we are gonna be talking all about investing and money. So everyone sit up straight, tip top, that's right. Oh, that's you too, that's right. Everyone here? Here we go. This is the story of a master with many, many servants. Once upon a time, there was a master who was very, very rich. I don't know how rich, but it was very rich, which means he had lots of money and lots of land and lots of servants. Well, this master had to go on a long journey, and so he called his three most important servants to him. And to the first servant, can you guess what he did? He gave 5 bags of silver. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 whole bags of silver, and told him, invest this, do something wonderful with it, so when I return, I can see what you've done. And then to the second servant, he said the same thing, only he only gave him 2 bags of silver, 1, 2, and said, invest it. I want to see what you've done when I return. And then to the third servant, he gave only 1 bag of silver and said, invest it. When I return, I want to see what you've done, and I hope it's something wonderful. Well, he went away on his long journey, and those three servants took the money. And the first servant, he did do something wonderful with it. He, well, did something like a lemonade stand or a bake sale, but the point is he earned 5 more bags of silver. So that made him have 10. And that second servant, he probably went into business with the first. We don't know how. Maybe he invested in Apple, but he also earned 2 more bags of silver. So he doubled the investment. And the third servant, well, let me tell you, it is not a pretty thing what he did. He was afraid, the Bible says. He was afraid of his master. He froze and didn't know what to do with that money, so he did not buy lemonade. He did not sell cookies. You know what he did? He buried that silver in a hole in the ground in the backyard. I just can't believe it. Pish posh, that is absolutely crazy. So that master returned from his vacation and called those servants to him and said, come, I want to see what you've done with the money I gave you. The first servant, he had 10 whole bags of silver. And the master said, well done, good and faithful servant. The second servant had 4 whole bags of silver. And the master said, well done, my good and faithful servant. And the last servant, he sheepishly pulled out his 1 measly bag of silver because he had frozen with fear and buried it. And the master said, heavens to Murgatroyd, what have you done with this 1 bag of silver? Nothing. Out with you. And he threw him out of his house because he hadn't done anything with the investment God had given him. And do you know, that reminds me of what God's Word teaches us. God has gifted every one of you with something special, and he wants you to multiply it. He wants you to invest it for his kingdom and do something wonderful with it. Isn't that wonderful? Every one of you is talented, and I love that. I can't wait to see and hear all that you all get to do for the kingdom of God. Now, I probably should get going. I think Apple closes pretty soon. Most markets do. Bye-bye, toodaloo.